My work designing and developing small commercial infill buildings began about a decade ago. I'm trained as an architect. I'm not an architect. I was working for a firm in town, Fletcher, Farr, Ayotte, and a lot of our dream clients were doing work that I'm doing now. And I really wanted to be involved in those projects. But my role at the firm wasn't as a designer. It was as a guy in the back corner doing seismic upgrades for public schools. And my wife would say, why aren't you doing those great fun projects? Well, A, there weren't any great fun projects coming along. And then B, if that dream client walked in our doors, they weren't gonna be hiring me, they'd be hiring my bosses. My shoulder wouldn't be the one tapped to design a building like this. It would be someone else who was known as a designer. So, realizing that I was in a rather passive role, I decided to take on a more active and risky role, which was being a developer myself, being that client. So I did have some rental houses as an architect or designer. I think it's important to work with your hands. So I bought in the Elliott neighborhood some old houses and fixed them up and kept them. I would take other developers out to coffee or lunch and I'd ask them silly questions. How do you be a developer? How can you succeed? What does a cap rate mean? What does a commercial lease look like? It turned out that it wasn't that complicated necessarily. It involved a lot of risk. It involved a little bit of money. So I decided to sell two rental houses and I bought my first piece of land over on 28th and Southeast Ankeny, where the Box and One now sits. That was my first project. I went to my bosses at Fletcher, Farr, Ayotte, and I asked if I could, because not being a licensed architect, I'm also not wanting to moonlight doing this. I worked 40 hours a week. I had, my son was just born, my first of now three, so I wanted to have a life still. I think a lot of us live in Portland because we cherish lifestyle. I wasn't willing to forgive that, or give that up, sorry. I asked my bosses if I could hire them, and then if they can then let me work on the project. So they agreed, which was nice. They had everything to lose, nothing to gain. And I would do the Box of One project, and I would design and draw the Box of One project. And every other Friday, I would get a paycheck, and then I would get an invoice for about three times the amount of that paycheck. And it just worked. I needed the supervision of Lynn Hibbert or Isaac Tebbett or Dale Farr to look over my shoulder and make sure the building was being done correctly and right. And at the end of the day, I was extremely proud of it. It won FFA a ton of design awards. And instantly, I went from being the guy in the back corner who was doing seismic upgrades to a designer. And it was a great way to change my role in the profession through a little bit of risk. And then the other fun thing is, I did the Ode to Roses building soon thereafter inside the firm. And the income from both those buildings was tiny, but still they both equaled my salary at FFA, so I could then quit my job and do this full time.